Hi new Photoshop users. This is a quick tutorial to just talk about JPEGs, Photoshop documents, and setting up how to save them and use them on your Mac. So one of the tutorials I think is great to get started on Photoshop is on flern.com. There's a 30 days of Photoshop. And on the second day, there are these two images and they're JPEGs. So for designers who are used to using images in Photoshop, we have our computers configured that a JPEG automatically opens in Photoshop. If you're new to having Adobe Creative Cloud, that's probably not set up that way. So if you have an image file and you control click on it and say get info, you will get this pop-up window and you can choose open with. And that's where you want to choose Adobe Photoshop. And you want to make sure that use this application to open all documents like this one, change all. By default, you probably have Apple's free program preview as the option, and your images probably keep opening in preview. So you want to change that default. So that's the first great tip to get started. All right, so once you have that done, all your JPEGs should open right in Photoshop. So let's say we have an image opened and we're going to go to Window Layers. All right, so you might already have that open somewhere. And a JPEG is a flattened image. It can have a color mode of RGB or CMYK, so for web or print, but it is one layer flattened. So you can see I have one background layer and it is locked. As soon as I unlock this and start doing other things, this can no longer be saved as a JPEG. You're going to have to choose to save it as a JPEG, right? I can't just click Command S for save. It will give me a save as option because it's not a locked background single file, right? So now if I go back and lock it and I do Command S, I have save as well. So it depends on your settings, but you can see down here, I have format. That is a option bar and you will have multiple options. You can see I do not have just JPEG right here. Okay, so you can also choose save a copy. And you can see I actually have a tooltip that says use save a copy for JPEG or PNG. Right, so that's going to be your secret power. If you do not know how to get an image saved as a JPEG, it's probably under save a copy. Now your format bar is going to give you a lot more options, right? And now I have regular JPEG, I also have PNG. All right, so the trick is to use save a copy. And you can also do that right from file, save a copy. And that will give you all of your options. But if you're just doing file, save, save as or save, it will pop up and your format may not have all your options. So again, look for save a copy if that happens. All right, so I hope this helps you find how do I save a JPEG and not just a Photoshop document, which is going to be the PSD. And your JPEG or the PNG option right here, again, is a flattened image, perfect for the web, does not have layers, can't go back and edit things that you've changed in Photoshop. All right, so here's just a small quick tip for beginners, and hopefully that helps you get started on your learning of how to use Photoshop.